All right. And sharing in the upper right, he is.
SK Telecom T1, Sue.
Okay, so Tasteless. It is Whirlwind. They're the top spots right now. Of course, Deer is going to be a little bit happier with that, especially with the location that he's in.
Yep, for sure.
The back side of Sue's base is a bit open to Deer here, and that's the positional advantage you want if it's going to be close.
Now, Zerg, throughout this game, is going to continue to expand down here towards the lower right. So this is going to be a situation where we actually have a lot of Protosses when they're doing the push, less focused on these expansions farther down in the lower right and more focused towards actually just pushing into the main, because the way Zerg operates with getting the lair and eventually the hive, most of their tech is in the second and the main.
Yeah.
So when you get up in there and you wipe that all out, it resets the Zerg. And the Protoss has a far too complex tech tree for the Zerg to dismantle off, you know, tier one hatchery tech.
Well said. You know, if you're trying to attack bottom right in these positions as Protoss, you're going to be so out of position, Zerg is going to be able to run circles around you. So that definitely is the fact. He's going to be going straight for the heart, most likely the natural, as the third base should be below.
All right, so we have the probe stalking the drone right now. He'll have confirmation that that third base is up and running. The gateway is about halfway done, and so far, this is all very standard stuff here for both sides.
Yeah, it's going to take a little bit till after the core finishes to really see what's going on from either player.
Okay, ooh. And I think we're already getting a glimpse of what that is going to be here.
A very sneaky move. This almost never works, but in that location, the fact that Sue has absolutely nothing down there, no Overlord, no drone, I think that this one's actually ended up working. Yeah, if he starts another cannon right now, one Zergling won't do anything against
that. Crouching probe, hidden cannons here.
Yeah, this is, well.
Oh my god. This is actually really bad, and he spots it!
Now that's exactly one cannon. Six Zerglings on the way. If he had started a second one, I would say 100% that's going down, but 12 links on the way. Can he save it?
It's also possible for him to block it off with more obstructions here. And these cannons are a perfect example of that. Now that queens are coming down here now. Now the fact that he's pulled both queens here means that Sue has to stop this attack.
All right, yeah, you are completely right, Tasteless.
I'm surprised he's taking the next cannon there. That's interesting.
That is,
don't know if I agree with that.
And that is enough Zerglings. He is not going to be losing his hatchery.
Yeah, not with the queens here especially.
Yeah,
I got to say, I'm a little bit disappointed with Deer's attack there.
Well,
he got the cannon up and running. I think if he had made the second cannon in time and then had the third one warping in, where the Zerg really has to make a call there.
If he had started both right away, and both at the same time, I think that he actually ends up killing the hatchery.
I think so.
But he did one, and the thing is, once they actually already have a pool out, one cannon like doesn't kill anything quick enough. You can actually make spines and defend it. Like, one cannon is not enough.
Yeah, this is also an odd move here with the Zealot.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel like Deer is actually starting to lose
momentum. You have to say he's behind here.
Yeah, well, absolutely.
Even though he forced some extra Zerglings and there was some missed injects from the queens, I have to say he's behind. The tech is a bit slow. There's enough Lings out the map that Sue is going to have at least map control for a little bit, despite not having speed yet. Everything's looking pretty good for him on a solid three bases with his creep starting to be spread.
Man, I got to go back to that cannon rush for a second here. I am so surprised at the kind of haphazardness of the rush, the lack of like real proper execution there.
The one thing I'm just really surprised about is the one cannon. I think that probably didn't happen much in practice, and he kind of just felt
kind of winged
it
there. He's like, I bet I actually could get this pylon up here.
Yeah,
but the problem is when you do cannon rushes like this and they fail, you're really behind, and also it messes with your tempo a lot.
It's
the natural rhythm of the game is not really there anymore.
A little bit rough, for sure.
Now he's going to try to sneak out a third base here while Zerg is in between tech here.
It's good timing. He's going to be able to get that up without any problems. Speed has just started. No sense in any Lings being made. I'd be really surprised if he actually makes any Roaches right now either. You know, This is looking like it's definitely going to go into a macro game.
Yeah. And the question now is, how can Deer deal with Sue, who should have a very solid standard macro game that really hasn't been tampered with at all? The only attempt to tamper was the Cannon Rush, which failed and actually put Deer in a deficit.
Well, right now, this is actually looking kind of interesting. This reminds me a lot of the Oracle build that Deer did earlier in this GSL Codex season. Of course, without an Oracle, but he's making a small group of Void Rays off one Stargate, which kind of makes you think it might be Sky Toss, but this is not a dedicated Sky Toss. This is a group of Void Rays for harassment and cleaning up the map, whereas he's actually getting a quick Twilight, which he's probably going to grab Blink with right away.
Yeah, this is pretty cool. Now we have Ranged Attacker being upgraded and 13 Hydralisks on the way.
And he actually is going to grab Charge. So Charge plus Temple Archives means, of course, we're going to have Quick Storm as well. And with the Hydras on the way, they're going to be... Well, he's still going to get some upgrades for them. You know, slow Hydras walking across the map are not going to be quite as strong against Zoggs.
Well, that's just such an unforgiving situation to actually be in, you know.
You mess that up one time, and that's it. So he is starting to move across. A lot more Hydras on the way. That Charge upgrade's still not completed. And we actually even have Roach Bro movement on the way.
All right, cleaning up that one Overseer. It looks like Sue might be a little bit hesitant about pushing any further forward here.
We do have the Infestation pick coming up. And
I like this taking the fourth there, by the way, for Sue.
You like that fourth base rather than a different one?
I would prefer it to be farther to the bottom right, but the fact that he's getting the fourth right now and not trying to just do some kind of three base timing
I have to agree with that. He definitely needs a fourth right now.
But I am also surprised it is up there. I feel like that's just...
It's an aggressive stance.
Yeah.
I think that part of that is to cut down on harassment. If he expands downwards, Warp Prisms become a lot more powerful, and even the Void Rays themselves become more powerful if they're flying around.
That is true.
Now that is a great scout timing, seeing when that infestation pit is done, but not upgrading and the layer not yet started. So he has a lot of information right now, doesn't know exactly what's going to be coming, but knows that he's going to have to check again in a minute.
Now we have the Zerg army grouped up here, just one queen with this army so far.
A very strong army right now.
Yep, and we got 130 supply to 155 here. Protoss is going to come up here and try to occupy this location on the high ground and expand there.
Well,
I'm going to say if he was holding that position up there on the high ground, that would be an easier spot to defend Mass Roach Hydra, you know.
Oh, certainly. There's no way Charge Lots can break that base. It's kind of like a forward base in ways. You know, he can attack out of there very quickly, but also a Charge Law based army cannot break it. If it was like a Colossus based army, you could push up there, but this one needs a more surface area than that.
And speaking about Colossus, we are going to have that coming in here in just a little bit here. Zerg just now hitting maxed out while Protoss is taking his fourth at about 3/4 of his entire supply completed. And you can see he's just running around with these few Zealots. These Zealots don't become as valuable sometimes later in the game. You need a few more tech units. So there's no real harm in just sitting him out and seeing if you can't catch a hatchery or anything like that. By the way, Warp Prism coming up here in towards the main, unloading Zealots now and warping in a slew more.
Whoa, that is a lot of Zealots being warped in at the moment. He's going for that morphing hive right now, in the same time pushing up towards that fourth, drawing the army back. And the army does go up to defend that fourth. In the meantime, these investors being worth a lot.
All right, he's trying to hit that fourth base. Meanwhile, we're going to have more Zealots come down here in the bottom right. He's essentially hitting three places at once. It's not clear if Sue can deal with this much happening all over the map.
Well, it looks like Deer is starting to get that hatchery.
Get that,
oh my god, if he can kill that, that
Oh, he
huge.
Will with these extra Zealots.
Oh, that's a big snipe right there, Tasteless. That really hurts the tech path.
Now
right
you got to keep
Sue.
In mind, though, there's a possibility of a Sue counterattack. Sue is maxed out, and this we did see Deer lose once like this already.
Yeah, and I believe Psystorm is still not done.
Whoa, so he almost did not get out of there. That was scary.
The splash damage available is actually pretty weak overall. It's going to be maybe three Colossi at this moment, or and going to be when it hits.
Look at the bank here. Look at the bank here for Sue. He can lose a lot of his army and remake that instantly.
Yeah, he can make a huge slew of roaches and almost just about remax out. Will he actually be able to hold on here? Now this army moving up into the third base right now of Deer.
Oh, really nice storms here, all three.
Oh God, yeah, I actually thought he did not have storm yet, but it looks like,
these are very good storms.
And it looks like this army, a huge amount of surface area on Deer right now. Stalkers coming in and doing a flank from the side, really pulling a lot of roaches away. Not many Hydras left, and these Colossus tearing through everything.
And the supplies now starting to even out where Zerg had a lead before. Meanwhile, the Warp Prism over here has not been used to warp anything else into the main, but probably will be shortly here. Also a strong chance that Deer is going to try to push forward and attack the base we have a shot of right now.
Well, this is looking really good for Deer Tasteless to slow down that Hive. To in fact reset, and they have to get the layer and everything. That means that your Colossus are going to be safe for so long. And oh, look at that warping, trapping the queen. He's going to get that infestation pit if he wants to. This is a tough spot for Sue right now.
Well, definitely enough over here to hold this off as he picks up and now tucks himself up into the upper right.
Now, I do have to say, even though it's four base versus four base, and the unit composition has to be seen as better for Deer, having Storm, having Colossus, having no Hive Tech for Sue, Sue's making a lot of Infestors. And
that
even though Infestors have been nerfed almost into the ground at this point from what they used to be, it's still a very strong unit. And
this
if Sue's
true.
Been practicing with them against Protoss, they have a lot of utility still.
All right, continuing to poke around the map and sending a few Zealots down here. Now, it's important to note that Sue is not expanding more. Here, he's staying on this base. They're both racing to try to get maxed up again. This is also a tough spot because neither player knows the other one's supply.
Well, they're both just about maxed out here.
Investors now moving out of the map. He's got to be careful with those, actually.
Yeah, you can't be losing them like that. Nice blink forward.
Yeah, and I noticed he always blinked in there with four.
Yeah.
So there was less of a risk.
Well, it's really smart not to overblink your units in. Now, he has so many Colossi Tasteless.
Yeah. And with this rock here like this, oh my God, I'm running into that storm.
Well, that's some good fungals, and he does come up with a bit of a flank, but the amount of Colossi, as well as these storms, and oh my God, just a brutal slaughter of the army.
Did that Colossus not die? That's it.
GG.
That's it.